हेलो, वेलकम टू सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ आवर लेक्चर। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ पैराग्राफ नंबर 3। दिस इज आवर पैराग्राफ। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम रीडिंग आउट दिस पैराग्राफ, लिसन इट केयरफुली। दिस डज नॉट मीन दैट द लैंग्वेजेस सॉरी This does not mean that the damages are negligible. It is probable that the liftman was much more acutely hurt by what he regarded as a slur upon his social standing than he would have been if he had a kick on the shins, for which he could have get a legal redress. The pain of a kick on the shins soon passes away, but the pain of a wound to our self-respect or our vanity may poison a whole day. I can imagine that Lipman denied the relief of throwing the author of his wound out of the lift, brooding over the insult of the hour and visiting his wife in the evening as the only way of restoring his equilibrium. For there are few things more catching than bad temper and bad manners. When Sir Anthony Absolute bullied Captain Absolute, the latter went out and bullied his man, Fag. Whereupon Fag went out downstairs and kicked the page boy. Probably the man who said top to the lip man was really only getting back on his employer, who had not said good morning to him because he himself had been henpecked or breakfasted by his wife, to whom the cook had been insolent because his housemaid had answered her back. We infect the world with our ill humors. Bad manners probably do more to poison the stream of the general life than all the crimes in the calendar. For one wife who gets a black eye from an otherwise good-natured husband, there are 100 who live a life of martyrdom under the shadow of a morose temper. But all the same, the law cannot become the guardian of our private manners. No decalogue could cover the vast area of offences, and no court could administer a law which govern our social civilities, our speech, the tilt of our eyebrows, and all our moods and manners. This is paragraph number 4. But though we are bound to endorse the verdict against the lip man, most people will have a certain. Now, again we start our paragraph number 3. What is the content part? What is given in this paragraph number 3? Here, writer wants to tell us, Gardiner assert that such damages are in no way negligible. The rude person's behavior towards the lip man must have seemed to be as an insult to his social position. This must hurt more than a kick on his shins, because he may get the law to act against the one who has kicked him, and in any case, the pain of a kick soon passes away. The wound caused to one's self-respect, on the other hand, does not heal easily. Gardiner imagines how the lift man must have brooded over the insult day, and how, upon returning home, he must have given vent to his anger upon his wife in the evening. Bad manners easily infect people who come across it. The author gives an example from a play. Here, name of the play is given, Rival Play. Here, Sir Anthony Absolute, page boy. This amusing incident is described in Act 3rd. That means this is the name of the play, Rival, written by Sheridan. A comedy by Sheridan. Sir Anthony is the Captain Jack Absolute's father, and Fag is the son servant. The author gives an example from a play, The Rival, by Sheridan, to illustrate the point in the play. in the play, Sir Anthony Absolute deceives his son, who gets annoyed and passes on his annoyance to his personal servant, who in turn goes and kicks one of the lower servants in the household. Trying to trace the root of the lead passenger's rude behavior, Gardiner guesses that the problem might have begun with the housemaid, who had been rude to the cook, who as a result might have been rude to his mistress, who in consequences might have passed on her annoyance to her husband, who ultimately passed on his annoyance by being rude to the lift man. Bad manners, in his opinion, are highly contagious and poison our life in general than the entire list of legally recognized crimes. If a woman is boxed by an otherwise gentle husband, there are many more who suffer in silence from bad temper. Yet the law cannot do anything in this regard. No decalogue could make a list of all the harm inflicted by manners, moods, facial expressions and the like, nor can this be dictated by any law. Okay, now again we go line by line and try to complete difficult words. This does not mean that damages are negligible. Negligible means to ignore, negligible. This does not mean that damages are negligible. It is probable that the lipman was much more acutely hurt by what he regarded as a slur. Slur means blot or shame, kalank, lanchan, as a slur upon his social standing than he would have been if he had a kick on the shins. What is the meaning of shin? Shin means the front part of the leg from knee to foot. Gurgha te paul, yamadil payacha jo pudcha bhag asto, tyala apan nadgi asa mhanto, tyala shin asa mhantat. Ja ya shin var lat marli, he had a kick on his shins for which he could have got a legal redress. Redress means compensation, bharpai. Legal compensation. The pain of a kick on the shin soon passes away, but the pain of a wound to our self-respect or our vanity means pride, may poison a whole day. I can imagine that lift man denied the relief of throwing the author of his wound out of the lift, brooding over means thinking anxiously or sadly about something, brooding over the insult by the hour, and visiting his wife in the evening as the only way of restoring his equilibrium. Equilibrium means balance. For there are few things more catching than bad temper and bad manners. When Sir Anthony Absolute, a bullied captain, bullied means threaten, Captain Absolute, the latter went out and bullied his man, Fag. This is the name of servant, Fag. Whereupon Fag went out downstairs and kicked the page boy. Don't do literal meaning. Page boy means pustak asla mulga vagare nahi. Page boy stands for a young male servant. Especially in medieval time, मध्ययुगीन कालखंडात पेज बॉय नावाची कन्सेप्ट होती. त्याचा अर्थ आहे लोअर लेवल सर्वंट, जो खालच्या पातळीतला नौकर आहे त्याला एक पेज बॉय असं संबोधतात. किक द पेज बॉय, प्रॉबेबली द मॅन हू सेड टॉप टू द लिफ्ट मॅन वॉज रिअली ओनली गेटिंग बॅक ऑन हिज एम्प्लॉयर हू हॅड नॉट सेड गुड मॉर्निंग टू हिम बिकॉज ही हिमसेल्फ हॅड बीन हिनपेक. Means the husband dominated by his wife. Baikoche varchasva asnara navra, tyala mhanta henpeck husband. Henpeck at breakfast by his wife, to whom the cook had been insolent. Insolent means very rude, because the housemaid had answered her